The means by which soaps kill insects is unclear. Let us review the requirements for insecticidal effects by soaps. Soaps work best on soft-bodied insects. Insects must come in direct contact with the soap. Soaps have no residual activity. Finally, soaps are only toxic when they are wet. There are several explanations that suggest how soaps kill insects. First, soaps may cause dehydration by disrupting the wax layer of the cuticle that protects the insect from water loss. Second, soaps may kill insects by cytolysis. Cytolysis is the release of cell contents by destruction of the cell membrane. Finally, soaps may cause suffocation. Soaps may wet the tracheal wax layer and fill the trachea with fluid in the same manner as was discussed for oils. Insecticidal soaps are potassium salts of fatty acids, of which oleic acid is an example. Soap molecules consist of a negatively charged acid group in a lipid chain that attracts fats and oily substances. In the scene describing soaps, we saw that soap molecules clump together to form micelles. Micelles are microdroplets of fats or oils suspended in water so that they appear to be in solution. Soap micelles have an outer ring of exposed acid groups and a fatty core of lipid chains. The outer electrically charged acid groups interact with water to hold the micelle in suspension. The micelle core attracts fatty or oily molecules and holds them suspended in the water by emulsification. Let us now see how soap micelles might interact with the insect cuticle. Insects are protected from water loss by the wax layer on their cuticle. Since waxes are fats and soaps emulsify fats, soaps are proposed to dissolve or disrupt the wax layers on the insect cuticle. When soap is sprayed onto the thin-walled insect species, such as an aphid, the soap wets the wax and spreads over the surface of the insect's body. Let us look at the cuticle again to see how the soap might affect the wax layer. Here we see droplets of soap spray falling on the outer wax layer and spreading over its surface. In this close-up view, we see how the soap micelles might interact with the fatty molecules that make up the two wax layers. The fatty chain of the wax molecules is drawn into the lipid core of the soap micelles. The wax molecules are suspended in the soap solution by emulsification and carried away from the underlying cuticulin layer. Destruction of the organized wax monolayer increases the permeability of the cuticle to the water. Therefore, insecticidal soaps may kill insects by dehydration after disruption and removal of the cuticle's protective wax layers. Soft-bodied insects are especially susceptible to soaps and die relatively rapidly in response to soap treatment. Let us now review a second way that soaps are believed to kill insects: direct damage to the internal body cells that leads to cellular destruction called cytolysis. Here we see a cross-section of the aphid abdomen. Droplets of soap spray land on the abdomen and the soap spreads quickly across the wax layer. The soap spreads along the wax lining of the trachea. Here we see one of the smaller trachea as it fills with soapy water. Soapy water fills the tracheoles down to the cells. The soap spreads from the tracheole over the surface of the cell and is absorbed into the cell membrane. A close-up will explain the action of the soap at the cell membrane. Cell membranes are a double layer of lipids. The electrically charged water-attractive ends of the lipid molecules are exposed on the inner and outer surfaces of the cell membrane. The long hydrophobic chains of the lipid molecules project inward from each side to form a water-repelling fatty core for the membrane. Micelles in the soap solution may be attracted to the membrane surface. Then the lipid core of the micelle is drawn into the hydrophobic core of the membrane. The micelles emulsify the lipids in the membrane, which leaves holes in the membrane through which the cellular cytoplasm and cell contents can leak out of the cell. As the soap spreads over the cell surface, the cell membrane deteriorates and the cell disintegrates and dies. From the perspective of the insect, the soap spreads throughout the trachea to each of the body cells, and the interior of the insect disintegrates. Then the insect dies. Suffocation by soaps will not be demonstrated. Suffocation by soaps is identical in action to the depiction of suffocation by oils.